Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. To my right is Mr. Aaron Ross. He created and plays the title character in The Ed Foreman Show, which is a live talk show extravaganza that happens Tuesday nights at Dante's in downtown Portland. You kind of typify something that is quintessentially Portland, which is the transformation of a certain part of town or the transformation of people after dark into something else. So downtown during the day is very much just a regular business district.
Right.
At night, it becomes this weird kind of burlesque in hell sort of a thing.
Yeah.
And you do that too. How important is that kind of Portland vibe to what you do?
Very. I mean, I don't think growing up in Southwest Portland, going to Wilson High School, I knew of that vibe. I think in high school I took the bus downtown twice. And I think once a friend of mine tried to steal a car or something to that effect. I didn't go downtown. And then when I, you know, went to college at PSU and then started doing the show, I'd been to Dante's once. I think I saw Eagles of Death Metal. Dante's is a crazy beast. And it has aided the show. It has pushed the show to places I didn't think it would go. The city has definitely changed what we thought. You know, there was not alcohol involved when we started it. You know, there was like in a theater, you know, I mean, it was still Ed Foreman, but now it's just like, it's a storm. It's awesome.
Do you think the show would work elsewhere? Do you think it would go over in other cities, or is it a Portland vibe centric?
We've been complimented by people from, you know, the LA, New York, and Chicago. I love doing it here. Not only am I from here, but I think we've got a great vibe. And I think when you do a show like what you're doing, I mean, you make it specific to wherever you are. And I think the goal is, regardless of who the guest is or whatever, is you're going to make it interesting. And I think any great host can do that. I think, you know, regardless of if it's, you know, you're interviewing the paperboy today because it's the news edition of the Ed Foreman Show, you will make that interesting.
Portland has so many people. I mean, but a disproportionate number of the people in the audience, for example, everybody is either in a band or working on a movie, or they've written a book, or they're working with a guy who's got a three-man show that he's going to be doing in seven parts, and it's half musical and it's half. But you've actually done it where you've taken your creation, your character, and you're on stage performing it every week. What was the sort of critical mass for you that where you just decided, like, I've got to put this in motion, and it's going to get on stage, I'm going to make it happen?
The Ed Foreman Show was a lark. January of 2008, we did it because I met a guy from Oakland that was like, saw me do Ed Foreman at the Boiler Room open mic. And he said, I'd like to do a show in a couple months. I'm coming back to visit. I've got 3 days. And I said, well, you saw Ed Foreman. I always wanted to do a late night talk show. You don't have to do anything but come in and co-host and improvise. We did that once. When we got done with that night, we said, let's tour for 2 weeks. And then it turned into 5 weeks. We got home from the five-week tour. We interviewed Sam Adams on the show. And after that night, we were just like, what do we do now? That was sort of big. We toured. We were not making any money, though. What do we do? And someone said to me, well, you got to figure it out. What do you want to do? I said, weekly. And it took a couple weeks, and we got Dante's through this and that. And it's the best job ever. It's great.
You can find out more about the Ed Foreman Show at what website?
We're on the MySpaces and the Facebook, so just go there and type in Ed Foreman, E-D-F-O-R-M-A-N.
Excellent. The Ed Foreman Show happens live Tuesday nights at Dante's. And now, our marquee sponsor, Things from Another World, presents the Outlook Portland editorial reply. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Paul Stanley of Kiss as a rubber duck.
All right! People of Portland, if there's one thing I know, it's about reaching for your dreams with both hands. And about having one foot in the gutter and one fist in the gold. As the philosopher Joseph Campbell said in his groundbreaking work, The Power of Myth, just as every dream has a moment of transcendent suspension, people, every journey has a beginning. Those journeys can be seen in their formative stages all over this fine city. So do yourself a favor and go someplace you might not have been to watch somebody you might not have heard of. Because, people, a city like Portland is like a daytime sky. It's filled with stars. You just gotta know how to look. Good night!
With an Outlook Portland editorial reply, that was Paul Stanley of Kiss as a rubber duck. Brought to you by Things from Another World. Whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection. I want to thank our guest, Aaron Ross, for being here today. My name is Rick Emerson, and if you find me even moderately amusing, you can find out more about me at rickemerson.com. You can also send us a guest, show, or topic suggestion. It is rick@outlookportland.com. Until next time, insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next Sunday right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen! Welcome to the Ed Foreman Show with me, Ed Foreman. You're having a great evening!
Are we laughing? Are we loving? Are we living? Beautiful kids, boys. Let's take it down. Everyone, please give it up for the Royal Flush.